Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on fault code P0442, symptoms, causes, and fixes. Fault code P0442 indicates an evaporative emission control system leak. Now, ultimately, the EVAP system in your vehicle is responsible for capturing fuel vapors and rerouting them back to the vehicle's intake tract, where they enter the cylinders and burn during the normal combustion process. So anytime you have an EVAP system leak, the PCM or the ECU will pick up on that, trigger the fault code P0442, and indicate that you have a leak coming from that evaporative emission control system. Moving on to symptoms of fault code P0442, this is very simple. A lot of the times when you have a small EVAP system leak, the only symptom is the check engine light. So that is by far the most common symptom. And again, in a lot of cases, that might actually be the only sign of the issue. In some cases, because this is a leak of fuel vapors being detected, you might notice some fuel odors around the engine or engine bay. However, it's not too common. A couple other symptoms you may see depending on the specific issue include rough idle, stuttering, and hesitation. And those are going to be more common if you have a specific issue like a bad purge valve or a bad fuel tank vent valve. And a lot of the times you will have an additional fault code indicating an issue with that specific component. So with symptoms out of the way, let's move on to the most common causes of fault code P0442. There is one cause that is by far the most common, and that is going to be issues with your gas cap. A lot of the times a loose gas cap or a damaged or faulty gas cap will trigger fault code P0442, as if your fuel tank and fuel cap are not secured, that can ultimately result in fuel vapors leaking out of the tank and triggering this fault code. So again, a lot of the times this is going to be by far the most common symptom if you simply forgot to fully tighten your gas cap, or potentially you have an older gas cap. It's very common for older gas caps to not seal properly. They might not click into place like they used to, and a lot of the times that can ultimately lead to a small leak of those fuel vapors, which will in turn trigger fault code P0442. Now, outside of that, there are quite a few other causes that can actually trigger this fault code, pretty much anything involving that evaporative emission control system. So some examples and some other common causes of P0442 include damaged EVAP system lines, faulty charcoal canisters, issues with the fuel tank vent valve, issues with the purge valve, the fuel tank pressure sensor, and then additionally issues with the fuel tank itself. So again, a bit of a lengthy list here. And with that P0442 code being very generic and just indicating a leak somewhere from the evaporative emission control system, ultimately anything within that EVAP system that could leak could certainly trigger this fault code. And so again, a lot of the times if you do have additional fault codes, that can be helpful in narrowing down the issues. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss the diagnostics and ways to fix fault code P0442. So the number one step is very simple. If you know that you have fault code P0442, you've probably already done this part, and that is starting with an OBD2 scanner and reading any fault codes stored in the ECU. The most important point here is to also double check what additional fault codes you have, since that can really help narrow down the specific issue that might be causing this fault code for you. For example, if you're receiving fault code P0449, that indicates an issue a lot of the time specifically with the fuel tank vent valve. So if you have P0442 and P0449, you can narrow down a lot of other things. Once you've done that, the next step in diagnosing and fixing this fault code is simply starting with the basics. Again, as I mentioned, the fuel cap is really going to be the most common cause of this fault code. So start there, check the gas cap, make sure it's tightened securely in place. And if you have one of the ones that normally clicks into place, make sure it's doing that and is obviously secured. Other basics to check: pop the hood, make sure there aren't any disconnected sensors, any noticeably damaged wires or lines running anywhere. Once you've done all of that, if you don't have anything pointing you in the right direction, it's time to do some more advanced diagnostics. And if you're not an experienced mechanic or DIYer, it might be a good time to just take it to a trusted repair shop and let them figure out the issues, as a lot of the times that can end up being cheaper and much less of a hassle than just kind of blindly throwing money at the car and fixing problems that might not even be an issue. So ultimately, if you are going to go ahead and tackle this, one of the best places to start is is doing a smoke test of the EVAP system. The smoke test will help indicate where that leak is coming from. Once you put smoke through the EVAP system, you can check, and wherever that smoke is coming out of, that can help narrow down and point to exactly where that leak is coming from. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.